So if you watched my previous video talking about the modification that I did on my Flux core welder, where I added a rectifier to turn it from an AC into DC welder, I had another issue. The controller for the wire speed, even if you turn it all the way down, still spits the wire too fast, and that creates inconsistent welding, and also it makes the welding pop during welding, and it makes the wire hits the puddle too fast, and that makes it loses the spark. So it makes the wire goes fast, and that makes the popping during welding, if you're familiar with that. So I decided to do modification on that. So by adding another resistor before the feeder motor, I'm going to show you what I did here. And it actually worked really well. And now it slows down the wire, and I'm able to fine tune it using the knob. So I'll show you how I did it. So if you remember the welder, it's 130 amps Mig welder, which is not really a Mig welder, it's a Flux core. As you remember in my previous video, I added this rectifier, and it really worked really well to turn it into a DC welder. And really reduce the amount of splatter and flashing. So another issue that I had which is the wire speed, and this is the wire feeder motor, and this wire feeder motor feeds out of the circuit board right here. So what I decided to do, instead of messing around with the knob, which is in the front right here, I decided to add a resistor. So this is a resistor that I got from an old phone charger. It was a Nokia phone charger, and it's a 10 ohm or something like that. And it really worked really well. When I measured the ohm between the two poles of the motor, it was about 5 ohms. So I decided, okay, if I add 10 more ohms, it will drop the voltage by half, and that will allow me a slower speed and better control of this. So this is what I did, is I just used my solder to take the wire off of the pole here, and just add the resistor in series, as you can see. And it did fix the problem that I had, and the welds that I've had after that have been actually better than the welds that I've had before that. I'm going to show you what it looks like. So I've been practicing my welding a little bit. So those are the welds that I've done before I fixed the wire speed control. Those are the welds that I've done after. So don't worry about those ones. Those are already grounded. Those were done before. But this one were actually done after I did the modification. Those one were done before, and as you can see, the inconsistency in the weld itself is a lot more than this weld here and this one. You can see that I'm able to do the circular motion, and it gives me a better control on the thickness of the weld itself when the wire speed is a little slower. So this is it for now. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you like it, please subscribe to my channel. I'm planning to add more videos of DIY modifications and things like that. I appreciate you watching the video, and I hope you enjoy it, and you like it and subscribe to the channel.